Hey guys, welcome to the Christy Glass Knits channel. Today, I swear I've talked about this chair somewhere in some way before, but maybe not. So I'm just gonna put it down as the rocking chair yarn bomb video right now, and it will all be just right here in this one place. And if for some reason I've talked about this and I don't remember, I apologize, but I just can't remember everything all the time. So this is my yarn bomb rocking chair. It's going on age 5 this year. It's been around a while and it really needs pruning. I call it pruning because yarn bomb gets a little crazy. So I was having my third child, and actually because there's a big gap between 2 and 3, I didn't save a lot of stuff because we live in apartments and it's hard to keep things, and I honestly wasn't sure I was having another baby. So I had to get everything new again, and because I was like very, very poor when I had my first child, I had the bare minimum of items. Like I'd never had a glider, changing table, like, I don't know, just things that I felt like everyone had, like swing, you know, walker. I didn't have any of those things. So I thought maybe a rocking chair might be nice to have, you know, but I do think like gliders are probably a lot nicer. But even though I could have maybe afforded a glider this time around, I just went with the old rocking chair. And I'm pretty sure that I ordered this from Urban Outfitters. And when it came, I was like, this is kind of an outdoor rocking chair, because I don't know if you can tell, but this is like, it's kind of like rope. Maybe we can get a close up later, but like right here you can see, listen to this. It's like twiny rope, and the whole thing was made of that, the whole thing. So actually it's kind of nice because you can go like this and scratch your back and it feels really good, but it's not really an indoor rocking chair, I don't think. So anyway, I got it, and then I don't know where it came from, but I just decided I wanted to yarn bomb my chair. So I reached out to, I think at the time I was doing more blogging, like typing, and I reached out to my friends and family through the blog and said, I want to yarn bomb this rocking chair and I want you to be a part of it. So friends and family near and far started making little swatches and sending them to me. So oh my gosh, I was so happy whenever the mail came, because my friends and family made these. Like, I remember this was Hannah's. She made it out of Noro. This was my mom's. She made a granny square. This is my cousin Amy, I think. This, I think, was my friend Carrie. I can't remember them all now because it's been so long, but it was really great. And I was just getting sort of back into, I mean, it had been a couple years, but I was like getting better at knitting and crocheting. So I also was doing some experiments like this. I don't know if you can tell, but this has some pom-poms on it. This one is one I made. My daughter, I think, made this one with holding two strands together, so she was pushing herself. And it became this awesome piece. Here's the back. This is a lot from my cousin Amy. She made some butterflies, and my dad even knit some. This is for my dad. There's a couple holes, but he did good. There's some for my dad in the front too, I thought. Oh yeah, dad did this orange one also. Yeah, there's a couple holes, but he did great. So, oh, and here's the seat. Can you see the seat? You can see the seat. This, a friend of mine got a new knitting machine, so she was experimenting with her knitting machine and sent some swatches over. Once I had all of these pieces, we had to figure out how to yarn bomb the chair. Now the cool thing about the chair, as I said before, it's like rope in here. So actually you could penetrate it, like you could get through the front and back. But what we did is I had a party, like I had all my knitter friends come over, and non-knitter friends, people who I thought could maybe, you know, I just told them what we were doing and they're like, I think I could help with that. So we all got together and we took the pieces, and it was kind of like a puzzle. So I think we had like painter's tape or duct tape, and we started taping the pieces to each shape. So we had a rectangle here, a rectangle on the back, and then the square for the seat. And we started taping, and once we thought it was all fitting to the rectangle, we took a picture of it with our phones, and then we started seaming it together with the yarn we had on hand. So you can see here's some green seaming here, here's some neon yellow here, you can see there's blue, and then other people who maybe weren't seaming, they started decorating the chair. So just wrapping yarn all around here and on here. This, the part on the seat has had the most wear and tear, but people were just sitting and wrapping the yarn everywhere. And then on the legs, there's some on the legs too. Let's see if we can get, you see the legs right here? Wrapping. So by the time the evening was up, like an hour or two, we were not even close to being done. So I ended up working on it for hours just myself. And when you're very pregnant, that is not easy. I was just like bent over with my giant belly trying to finish this thing. And I mean, it's pretty finished. Like, it's close. It took me several other sessions, but we just sewed it on. This is literally sewed on. And by the time we had these two pieces on, we were sewing back and forth because it was getting, you had to make sure that all of the parts were secure, like not just around the edge, because it would just move. See, it's not moving very much because we really made sure we would put the needle in back and forth in different places to secure it. So it's actually held up really, really well. It's the wrapping that hasn't held up as well. But one thing that's cool, if you want to make something like this and you don't want to involve other people, if you are a big knitter like I am, or a big crocheter, you can take all of your swatches and use your swatches for this. So I ended up adding more. So like, this is a swatch from a purse that I made right here. You can tell it's a swatch because it's like, I do a right side and a wrong side sometimes when I swatch. This is a swatch from something. One day I was determined to learn how to make granny squares because I didn't know how to make granny squares. So this is one of my first attempts at the granny square. This, actually, I did some yarn bombing one year. I did this road trip with my girls and we decided to yarn bomb our way across America. And I yarn bombed a rock in front of a house in my mom's neighborhood in Naperville, Illinois. And every year, you know, every time I went back to my mom's house, you know, maybe every 6 months or something, I would drive by this house and it was still on the rock, this yarn bomb. I was like, I cannot believe they've kept it there. And it was getting so faded that I decided to replace it. And so this was on a yarn bomb rock for years in someone's yard. And then I took it and replaced it with a new one. And I put it on my chair to remember. So the chair can, you know, mean different things. Like here on the bottom is part of a hat. Like I was making a Halloween costume for my daughter and I think it just didn't fit her. I think it was too small. And so I started over, but I didn't rip it out. And so this actually is a little hat that I just added on. This is some art yarn that I got. Probably my first art yarn that I ever bought. Like, probably at Renegade or something like that. And it just wasn't quite enough to make something else. So I just stuck it on the chair. So I hope that gives you some ideas and some inspiration to yarn bomb something in your life. I get so many compliments on this chair and I feel like it's just a wreck now. I feel like it's ready for a new life. So I need to prune it. I think it just needs a little tender loving care and it will be better. But I get a lot of compliments on this chair and it really is a wonderful piece for my life and for my family. So that's the story of the yarn bomb rocking chair. And let me know what you've been yarn bombing. Do you yarn bomb any, have you yarn bombed anything in your own house? How did you do it? How did it go? And I want to see a picture of it. Can we share pictures on YouTube in the comments? If not, just tag me on Instagram or something, okay? All right, thanks for stopping by. Christy Glass Knits. Bye!